7:28 of overtime. The time of the goal by Anze Kopitar, who standing by with a smile on his face with Scott Oak. Scott.
Jim, thanks very much. Yes, Anze just had a chance to have a couple of looks at the OT winner. And the first thing you said when you saw it the first time was lucky. I guess to have it go off the knob of Luongo's stick would make it that.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, I know it's a cliche. And, you know, we put puck to the net and good things will happen. And obviously I was... It was great power play for us. You know, we were moving the puck all night, I think, around pretty good. But then, you know, to top it off like this, it's really nice to see.
Well, you were just saying he stopped it once. You can't expect him to stop it twice.
Well, I mean, he made an unbelievable save, you know, the other day in game one. And, you know, we were lucky to squeeze one in like that.
Anze, it seemed to a lot of people that the Los Angeles Kings were a more confident team heading into overtime in Game 2 than you were in Game 1. Is that a fair assessment?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, you know, it's one of those things when, you know, I know it's not a lot of experience, but the Game 1, you know, we're kind of touching, you know, what's going on the ice. And, you know, in Game 2, I mean, tonight we just went after it. I mean, that's what you got to do. And all the coaches are saying put the puck in the net and good things will happen.
Well, listen, power plays occur in overtime, not a lot, but when the call was made tonight and you knew you had the man advantage, what were you thinking?
Just go out there and, you know, try to execute as much as we can. You know, we have some set plays that we, you know, we go through throughout the game, and, you know, it worked out good for us.
Thanks, Anze. Congratulations on the OT winner.
All right, thank you.
Anze Kopitar, the Los Angeles Kings, delivers his team to victory in Game 2 of this conference quarterfinal. Studio 42, Ron, Glenn, and Kelly, up next.